We're back with you from the Pitt Center at Sacred Heart. Quinnipiac, a dominating performance tonight. They win it 86-71, and Paul Dottino is standing by with the victors.
Thanks so much, Dave. Tom Moore, the victorious head coach tonight. We'll get to him in just a second. James Feldeine is our player of the game. 27 points on 11 of 14 shooting, which is really sensational. Sizzling hot. When do you know that it's going to be your night?
First couple shots. If I hit my first shot, I'm really on. I know I mentally, I'm like, all right, I'm going to make my next three shots, four shots. So as soon as I hit the first shot, I knew I was going to have a good night.
Now, Jerry O'Connor was telling us at halftime even, it didn't seem like it was all about you. You were getting all of these points, but it was all within the flow of the offense. How do you make that happen so smoothly?
Coach Moore. That's all I got to say is Coach Moore. He teaches me real well in practice. Make sure I come off screens well. I get my shots during the offense. I don't force that many shots. So it's all to him. Coach Moore teaching me real well right now.
Okay, now the second half of this rivalry week, you have this home and home on Saturday. You play Sacred Heart again. What do you do differently, or do you just do the same things again?
Same thing. We focus on Corey, so we did a great job today. James Johnson did a great job. So if we stop him, we're going to be real good.
Okay, James, best of luck. Thank you very much. Our player of the game is James Feldeine. His coach is Tom Moore, the guy he credits with all of this wonderful play. So how easy is it to coach him?
He's been great. I mean, he's a great success story, Paul. You know, he went from not playing hardly any minutes his freshman year. And the growth that he's had, both on the court and off the court, has been phenomenal. I mean, he's a 1,000-point scorer, done a great job in the classroom for us. And he's just a kid, I think, when I got there, who wanted to be loved, wanted to be coached, wanted to be directed. And when we push, he's good. I mean, we keep pushing him, and we keep trying to set the bar higher for him. And he bounced back terrifically from a rough night at Mount St. Mary's tonight and didn't lose any ounce of confidence, and real tribute to his character.
Now, you're in a battle with Robert Morris at the top of the NEC standings. You've been dominant at home. But I thought today you showed a lot of road toughness. Can you build off of this by winning some more on the road?
Yeah, you know, I hope so. We go down there in a couple weeks. But fortunately for us, we got three straight home games now starting Saturday with these guys again. So, you know, it's the old cliche. You got to take them sort of one at a time. But I'm happy with the resolve we showed, that toughness word again. And, you know, we talk about defense a lot. We were first or second in the league in field goal percentage defense. And James Johnson, again, like James just said, he just sort of gave up his whole night to just try to get in Corey Hassan's shorts and stay with him wherever he went. And he really did a great job. I mean, Corey moves so well without the ball. And James was phenomenal. I mean, he did a great job. And Justin Ruddy, I thought, was really strong despite the foul trouble inside. John Cruz, again, too, tonight was a real stabilizing force, played very smart for us and was a real veteran out there.
Tom Moore, thanks very much. Best of luck.
My pleasure, Paul. Thank you.
Okay, fellas, back to you.
All right, Paul. Justin Ruddy at 22.